Hello all, in today's video we are going to discuss about another application layer protocol, SNMP, Simple Network Management Protocol. Before going to learn about SNMP protocol, let me tell you the functionalities of a network management system. A network management can be defined as monitoring, testing, configuring and troubleshooting. So the functionalities of a network management system include configuration management, fault management, performance management, security management and accounting management. Configuration management is related with reconfiguring the network entities as they are initially configured in a network, but with time they have to be reconfigured. So reconfiguration of the hardware or the software or the user accounts, all these have to be reconfigured and all this information has to be documented. That is done by configuration management. Fault management, it is concerned with the damage or issues in the network components that can be done reactive or proactive. We can have a reactive measure or a proactive measure, where in reactive measure we will detect the fault, isolate the fault, correct the fault and record the fault, whereas in proactive measure we will try to predict and prevent the faults before they occur. Then performance management. Performance management is about monitoring and controlling the network to ensure that it is running efficiently. So that might include the various factors on the capacity of the network, monitoring the capacity, traffic, throughput and response time. For example, you're monitoring the capacity of the network where you are looking up to what is the capacity of the network and how much load you are putting onto it. How much is the traffic, the internal traffic and the external traffic. All these things are being monitored in performance management. Security management involves controlling access to the network based on a particular policy, so that we do not have any unauthorized access to the network. Accounting management. Accounting management deals with the control of user access to network resources, such that we charge the devices for the services they receive from the network. That is about accounting management. So all these are the functions of a network management system, and these are implemented using a protocol called as SNMP. Using a protocol called as Simple Network Management Protocol, which has to take care of all these functionalities. Let us see what is the concept of Network Management Protocol, wherein we have the format has two entities here, where SNMP is a framework for managing devices in an internet using the TCP/IP protocol suite. It provides a set of fundamental operations for monitoring and maintaining the internet. So we will have a concept of a manager and agent here, where a manager controls and monitors a set of agents. A manager controls and monitors a set of agents. A manager is a host, whereas an agent is a router or another host. Okay, so SNMP can be used in LANs and WANs connected by routers. So a manager or a management station will run a SNMP client program, whereas an agent will run a SNMP server program. As you all know, all application layer protocols are client server programs. So basically, the interaction between a manager and an agent will take place like this. An agent keeps performance information in a database. An agent will keep all its performance information in a database, and a manager will have access to this database, access to the values in the database with which it can understand the performance of the agent. For example, a router is storing in variables such as the number of packets received and the number of packets forwarded. So what a manager will do, it will compare these two variables. If these two variables values are not matching, it can understand that there was congestion because the values are not matching. The packets received were 5, forwarded were only 3. That means 2 were lost. Maybe this loss is due to congestion. That means there is traffic. That means there is some performance issue. So all this has been notified to the manager by the cooperation of agent. So management with SNMP has basically 3 ideas. The 3 ideas are: a manager checks an agent. A manager will check an agent by requesting information that reflects the behavior of the agent. Okay? A manager forces an agent to perform a task by resetting values in the agent database. And an agent will contribute to the management process by sending warning messages to the manager of an unusual situation at its place. This warning message is called as a trap. So this is how the network management process will take place. So basically, to do this, the network management has 3 components here. SNMP is the main component as such, but it makes use of other 2 protocols called as SMI and MIB, where SMI is structure of management information and MIB is management information base. That means you need to, as I told you, the manager has to have access to all the information provided by the agent. This information control is done by SMI, that is structure of management information, and the management information base. What basically SMI does, SMI defines general rules for naming objects, defining object types, and showing how to encode these objects and values. So it basically provides you with a object identifier. It provides us with an object identifier. Whereas the basic purpose of MIB, Management Information Base in SNMP, is to provide a standardized framework for organizing, retrieving, and configuring the data on the network devices. What MIS is doing, it is only specifying the SMI, what SMI is doing, it will only specify the general rules for defining or naming the objects using an object identifier. But the relationship between all that is given by MIB, where MIB is a framework that provides standardized way for organizing, retrieving, and configuring the data on network devices. It allows the network administrator to effectively monitor and manage the network performance and configurations across various devices. So all these work together for network management. So what does this network object attributes include? They include the name of the object, type of the object, and the encoding method. What is an object identifier? How does it look like? An object identifier is basically defined by using hierarchical identifier based on a tree structure. The tree structure starts with an unnamed root. We have integers separated by, each object can be defined by a sequence of integers separated by dots. All objects managed by SNMP are given an object identifier. So these object identifiers will help us in identifying the object, whereas MIB will provide relationship between these objects. Now let us see the general operation of SNMP. What basically happens? We will make use of messages like UDP connect. We are making you a UDP connection between the SNMP client and SNMP agent, where it will give a PDU called as get request, which is sent from the client to the agent to retrieve the values of the variables. Get next request is another PDU sent from agent to retrieve the value of a variable. Get bulk request is another PDU sent from the client to the server, that is from the manager to the agent, to retrieve a large amount of information. Set request is a PDU sent from the manager to the agent. Set from the manager to the agent to set or store a value in a variable. Then the agent will give a response PDU which is sent from the agent to the manager in response to all these requests made. Whenever there is an unusual situation at the SNMP agent, what the agent will do, it will send a PDU called as a trap. This message is sent to inform the manager and report it to reboot because there is some problem. Then we have another PDU sent like inform request and report are sent to the other agents that it is controlling. So this is how the network management protocol works, by controlling a manager controlling different agents. So this is about your last application layer protocol, that is SNMP. Thank you.